Today, I want to talk about the theme of continuing the legacy of excellence. As a product of this great institution, we all have a responsibility to uphold the standards of excellence that have been set before us. You are the product of hard work and dedication. Of all those who have come, that have went before us, have gone before us, it is our turn to carry on their legacy. Over the years, indeed, the school has been a breeding ground for exceptional individuals who have gone on to achieve great things in various fields. In the field of academics, medicine, health, arts, athletics, community service, just to name a few. I see we have Dr. Corey Ford, who is, we know, is the head of the isolation center, and he's an infection control specialist. There are persons like Valmus Canterbury, who is the first black female transplant surgeon from here in these halls. Kathy Harper Hall, she's program director of Sports for Life, teaching persons how to use sports to have a better life. And we cover all spheres and directions. We have Philip Antoine, who is a nationalist mythologist. Reverend Harcourt Blackie, who would have led the church, Catholic Church on Black Rock, who have interacted many times as a young man there playing chess, and he provided his space for us. And if this could go on, I don't want it to cool anyone, so let me pause on that, you know. It goes on. This legacy is not just mere accolades, but is a responsibility that you, myself, all of us have to carry wherever we go. And I ask the question, what it is or what does it mean to continue the legacy of success? Success is not just about achieving your goals. It's also about leaving a positive impact on the world around you. It's about making a difference in the lives of others and contributing to society in a meaningful way. The legacy of success that we have inherited is not just about our achievements, list of achievements, but it is about, in my view, a set of values and principles that we should strive to uphold. Alles non sibi, for others, not ourselves. And in that spirit, and in keeping my speech short, it gave me 20 minutes. I'm going to lay out what I believe for you, the three main values or principles that we have been instilled upon us and that we must take forward. One of the most important of these values that this school has instilled upon us, I keep saying us because I want to keep reminding, I'm a product of this great institution, is the importance of hard work. Nothing in life comes easy, and it's through hard work and dedication that we can achieve our goals. Former US President Theodore Roosevelt said, "Nothing worth having comes easy." Success is not handed on us on a silver platter. It requires dedication, it requires perseverance, and a willingness to put in the effort. Even the good book told us, and it charged us by saying, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters, since you know that your inheritance is from the Lord. So as you embark on your chosen paths, whether some are here, some moving on, remember that success is not just about achieving your goals, but it's about the effort you put in towards achieving them. To stay true to this value that this institution has taught us, it is essential to set clear goals and make a plan to achieve those goals. Find ways to motivate yourselves, whether it's through rewards, accountability, self-talk. I do that every morning. To this day, I wake up and I tell myself, Kevin, you are great. But today, you're fabulous. You got to speak to yourself every day. Not people will tell you who you are. Remember, also you need to remember that setbacks and failures are just opportunities to learn and grow. So don't give up when things get tough. Keep pushing yourselves and giving your best effort. In fact, how can we stay motivated and committed to hard work when life gets challenging? My advice is that one key way is to stay focused on the why. Why do we want to achieve our goals? And how will they contribute to your personal growth and to the betterment of our community? By keeping our purpose in mind, we can overcome obstacles and stay motivated even when things get tough. Another value that you would have gotten from this great institution which guides me up to today is that of integrity. As we must always strive to uphold the importance of integrity. As a former U.S. Supreme Justice, Sandra Day O'Connor once said, integrity is the lifeblood of democracy. So to stay true to this value is essential to be honest with yourself and with others. Be transparent in your actions and your decisions. Don't compromise your values for personal gain. Treat others with respect, even when you disagree with them. In fact, I would say even more when you disagree with them. And be willing to admit your mistakes and take responsibility for your actions. That's a hallmark of integrity. Integrity is not just about doing the right thing when people are watching. Indeed, it is also about doing the right thing when no one is watching. This can be challenging, especially when there are temptations to cut corners and take shortcuts. But by staying committed to our value and principles, we can build trust, respect, with others and live a life of integrity. I've been a spiritual man with leave a quote, add a quote from the Bible where it says, the integrity of the right guides them, but the unfaithful are destroyed by their duplicity. Integrity is the second one I want to add. Another very important value that this school instilled upon us is that of compassion. Mother Teresa, no greater person, said, not all of us can do great things, but each one of us can do some small things with great love. Compassion means showing kindness and empathy to all those around us, especially the less fortunate. It means using our skills and talents to make a positive difference in this world, to stay true to this value of compassion. You must practice empathy and understanding. You must try to put yourself in person's shoes and consider their perspective. Indeed, volunteering your time and resource to help those in need. And try to be a positive influence to those around you. Remember that small acts of kindness can have a big impact on someone's life. I try to live this every day. I tell my staff, my management team, they too should practice simple things. Like I try to bless someone every single day. I go my way to find someone to bless. It might be a cup of coffee. It could be a kind word. It could be just listening to them. But you try to bless someone every day and you develop an attitude and a culture of compassion. It's a kind of a growth mindset we have to have. Instead of judging people and labeling them, we should try to see them as individuals with unique experiences and challenges. And by approaching others with this open mind and indeed an open heart, we can build empathy and understanding and have a positive impact on the world around us. My final value that I want to speak on, that I have learned from this school and I know that you have been instilled upon you, is that of building a strong community, the value of community. The late former South African President Nelson Mandela said, no one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin, his or her background, or his or her religion. People must learn to hate. And if they can learn to hate, they can learn to love. They can be taught to love. For love comes more naturally to the heart than the opposite. So building a community for me means reaching out to those around us regardless of their background or their beliefs. It means finding common ground and working towards a common goal. To stay true to this value is essential to stay connected with others and build strong relationships. Find ways to support and encourage each other and your peers, whether it's through offering some help, attending events, or simply being present, just showing up to community activities, party posts. Join a club, join an organization that aligns with your interests. When I was at school, I was into chess, and later in life, I joined ballroom dancing in the school Christian fellowship. Things that align with your interests. Get involved in community projects. They can make a difference. Indeed, building a community also means being open to diverse perspectives and ideas. You shouldn't be afraid to engage in civil discourse with those who hold a completely different view from you. You should seek to understand their perspective and find common ground from which you can build and move ahead. And by building those bridges and connections with those around us, we create a more inclusive and harmonious society. One of my principal advice in this area would be willing to be vulnerable and be authentic. Many persons would have known or heard me talking about where I came from, my background. You know, I mean, doing so, you have to be willing to open yourself to persons. Person would have heard that I would have, as a young man, spent some time in a children's home. That allows me now to connect the younger persons who are going through rough and trying situations. You have to be authentic. You have to be willing to be vulnerable if you're going to build strong community. And you, young people in this position, you are the next thread in that community. And you must build those around you. Start with those immediately around you. As I say, you have to be present, to be engaging. Attend activities, participate in group discussions and projects. Listen attentively and ask questions. Share your perspective, engage other person's perspective. You must be willing to support others and encourage them in the journey, open to feedback and criticism. Let me sum up, as I promised to keep it short. I congratulate each and every one of you at where you are now, where you're going, whether it be a higher form, whether it is going on and leaving, but wherever you are. Let us remember the values and principles that this institution is still upon us all. Let's continue the legacy of success by staying connected to higher work, integrity, compassion, and community. Remember, you're all capable of great things. Ayes non sibi, for others, not ourselves. Thank you, and the best of luck in your future endeavors.